All right. Good morning again, Sock Nation. So may I have attention again? We will be starting the celebration program in 2 minutes. Again, we'll be starting the celebration program in 2 minutes. If you are an alumni, we do have alumni seating by the decades to my right. If you are faculty staff and you would like to sit on the left, you are welcome to do so. Our elected officials and VIP and dignitaries will be sitting on the floor. Thank you so much. All right, good morning again, everyone. We'll be starting the program in 3 minutes. 3 minutes. All elected officials. Thank you. program. So at this time, can you please take a seat? Again, you guys, we're about to start the program, so please, at this time, please take a seat. So again, good morning to our students, faculty, and staff of South Oak Cliff High School, to our community members and leaders, and of course, the alumni of one of the most prestigious schools in the city of Dallas, South Oak Cliff High School. There you go, thank you. All right, before we get started, I want to take this time to recognize three organizations that have used sweat, blood, and tears to put all of this together. None other than the Sauk Alumni Bear Cave, Alumni Association of South Oak Cliff High School, the Next Generation Action Network, and the DFW Elite News. Without these three organizations, we would not be celebrating this awesome and momentous occasion. And so with that being said, again, my name is Brianna Hogg, representing the class of 2011 of the South Oak Cliff High School, and administrative secretary of the Sauk Alumni Barricade, and I'll be serving as your mistress of ceremony for this event. High School choir singing Lift Every Voice and Sing, and also we'll have our opening prayer by our Sauk Alumni Barricade President Horace Bradshaw, the class of 1977.
words of our keynote speaker today. I'm hyena happy and peacock proud to be here today. We have come a long way, and like our elders say, we come this far by faith. Let us pray. Eternal Father, our God, how we praise, magnify, and adore thy holy and righteous name. Father, we come to you with thanksgiving on our hearts today for the great things that thou have done in our life. We thank you, dear Lord, for the journey. We thank you, dear Lord, for the struggle, because it didn't break us, but it has made us and it will continue to make us. We thank you for this facility, dear Lord, that we sit in today. And we thank you, dear Lord, for allowing those who organize protests to be steadfast in their conviction, wouldn't accept no for an answer. But in the spirit of leaders like the late Al Lipscomb, and those who sat in here today, John Wiley Price, Eddie Bernice Johnson, and so many more who dare to speak truth to power. We thank you, dear Lord, for the spirit of protest. Malcolm X, Martin Luther King, Marcus Garvey, leaders that inspired us to be more than what we were told that we were. In that spirit, dear Lord, we sat in this building today when they told us it couldn't be done. All you people do is party, go to the park. You will never organize. $60 million later, we sat in this building. And we say, dear Master, the fight has just begun. We thank you for the spirit of protest. Never again, dear Lord, will we accept our elected officials to dare come to us and tell us that some money is better than no money. No, no, no. We demand equity. Equality is the spirit of the day. Lord, we don't come to you saying we want to pray for our enemies. Not in that vein. We pray, dear Master, that you move our enemies out the way. Those who were there redline our district. Those who would dare try to deny us basic human rights. We pray, dear Master, no, not for their prosperity, but that you remove them out of our way so we can march on in victory. Our children need us to stand strong. The Fab Four in the class of 2016 have spoke loud to us that in the spirit of protest, we can do all things through Christ who's strengthening us. Let us not just allow that to be words, vain words coming out of our mouth, but let us march on in that spirit that we can do all things through Christ who's spirit strengthening us. Allow your spirit, dear Lord, to radiate through this building in such a way, dear Lord, that our students and our teachers will demand excellency. That our students and our teachers will expect the best out of one another. We can do it, dear Lord, because we serve a God that sits high and looks low. We give you all the praise and the glory for what you have done and what you shall do and what you are doing right now. It's in the name of Jesus that we pray and ask it all. Amen. And thank God.
Reverend Bradshaw. Never fails. Never fails. As most of you know, Mr. Bradshaw, representing from the class of 1977, has not only been vital to just his class, but to all of South Oak Cliff High School. So it's only right that we give him an award. Thank you again, Reverend Bradshaw. At this time, it gives me great honor to introduce to you another awesome alum of South Oak Cliff High School, represented from the class of 1998, none other than Gary Bird, who will be presenting to you the history of South Oak Cliff High School.
Good afternoon. All right. The Dallas Public School System was first established in 1884 by the state superintendent of schools, Benjamin Banneker and William Carvel, the mayor of Dallas. Due to Jim Crow laws, segregation was a legal requirement back then. Six schools were in operations. Four schools were designated for whites and two were designated for blacks. In 1915, Oak Cliff High School and Forest Avenue High School were built. Oak Cliff High School was renamed W.H. Anderson in 1935 after its beloved principal. And Forest Avenue was renamed James Madison later on in 1956 when due to the 1954 Topeka Brown versus the State Board of Education, which allowed the first black student to attend Forest Avenue. And that was in order to relieve overcrowded Booker T and Lincoln. Over the next four decades, Dallas ISD expanded and became one of the largest districts in the state, with the annexation of several districts across the city. A proposal for a new South Oak Cliff High School was first presented to the Dallas School Board in March 1935. The purpose was to relieve overcrowded junior high school classrooms, improve student commutes, and cut down on student dropouts who had to drop out of school to take care of families. In 1938, a group survey was given to the Lisbon and Trinity Heights areas demanding a new South Oak Cliff High School. South Oak Cliff boosters quickly began to form. In 1945, a proposed budget was granted to the South Oak Cliff Booster Club for $10 million with the plans to build a new South Oak Cliff High School. However, in March of 1948, Superintendent of Schools W.T. White postponed plans because he wanted to cut down on the distance the student traveled from their destinations in Lisbon and Trinity Heights. And he said it was no greater than the distance of the student that went to school in Love Field. And petitions were quickly circulated throughout the Lisbon, Trinity Heights, and South Oak Cliff area. On March 8, 1949, which is now officially the Founders Day of South Oak Cliff High School, they met at Balstory Junior High to vote on to rename the school South Oak Cliff High School. which was designated for whites. Although the new plans were revised three times, on December 29th, board members spoke with South Oak Cliff, the Booster Club of South Oak Cliff, at a luncheon at the Baker Hotel and promised that they would get a new school by September 1951. On September 16th, 1950, South Oak Cliff Booster Clubs, Jason F. Kimball, R.L. Thomas, and the Dyer Construction broke ground on the 15-acre land that we now see on Marsalis and Elton Road. South Oak Cliff is the 10th high school to go up in Dallas, the third in Oak Cliff, and is set to blaze the trail for four schools to go up in a three-year span. That was Jefferson, Adams, Kimball, and Samuel. South Oak Cliff unofficially opened the door in September of 1951 to 107th graders from Balthorpe Junior High. The first official students who attended South Oak Cliff High School were 136 low sophomores from Balthorpe Middle School, and this class made up the first official class that graduated in 1954. The 60s saw a rapid change of black families moving into the area. In 1963, two more schools were built, Roosevelt and Pinkston. That same year, a preliminary court order forced all Dallas schools to open up its schools to all races. The first black student integrated to SOC in 1965. The first black principal was a young educator named William Cotton, who came to South Oak Cliff in 1967 and later came principal in 1970. By 1983, South Oak Cliff and Roseland have reached 3,000 and had a separate ninth grade wing. Another addition was added in 1988 and another one in 1990. The school library was renovated. Despite these additions and renovations, the structures were showing signs of decline. Several problems built up over the next decade, creating an unsafe learning environment for the students. As early as 2008, the South Oak Cliff Alumni Barricade, the staff, concerned parents, and the South Oak Cliff community met with trustees of the district, Superintendent Michael Hinderhogan, to discuss the deterioration of the nearly 70-year-old building. There were several attempts to push for a new school. The fight for equality was bigger than South Oak Cliff. The community of South Oak Cliff also sought justice for all its neighboring schools in the southern sector. This fight was about securing equity for the students of color. A gas leak in November of 2015, coupled with the failure to evacuate the school, enraged student, parents, and the community. This incident garnered much of community attention and support and set the stage for the student walkout to take action. On December the 7th, the Fab Four, the senior class 2016, led by Landon Finley, T. Mitchell, Lizette Gonzalez, and David Johnson, organized a student walkout during instructional hours to protest the conditions and demand educational equality. Over 450 students protested, further uniting the South Oak Cliff community. This expression was paramount and subsequently enabled South Oak Cliff alumni stakeholders, Dallas ISD officials, and the school board trustee to negotiate a bond package for school renovation. In May of 2017, the Dallas Board of Trustees unanimously approved a $62 million bond for gut renovation of the existing building. The renovation of the mighty South Oak Cliff High School began in January of 2016, 68 years after the original school was built. And all I can say is that 2 years later, mission complete.
Now, you guys, let me tell you something about Gary. What you just guys heard was just a small taste of the history of South Oak Cliff High School. Gary actually came up with almost over 12 pages of this history. And also, you can learn more about the history in the DFW Lee News newspaper, which has been published, and again, presented by none other than Gary Bird, the class of 1998. So again, let's give him a round of applause. Now, at this time, we have a few remarks, and I would like to call each gentleman up to the stage, one at a time. But first, we'll start with our own head principal, Dr. Willie Fred Johnson, Jr. of South Oak Cliff High School. And next, we will then have Maxie Johnson, Dallas ISD Board of Trustees, District 5. And last but not least, Dr. Michael Hinojosa, Superintendent of Dallas ISD School.
Let me begin by saying it is a privilege to address distinguished guests. First of all, my parents are in the building, so you can give them a hand. My wife and student kids, teachers, parents, and community. As we attempt to reculture the 75216 corridor, and that's an in-house thing because we're tired of losing our kids to gun violence. I'm gonna say that one more time. We are tired of losing our students to gun violence. So as we attempt to reculture 75216, notably partnering with Trust for Public Land, in late spring, we will break ground on the Alice Branch Creek Park project right behind the football field, offering the community additional green space and walking trails. Our new neighbor right across the street, Randy Bowman, and at last will soon open his doors, providing additional support Monday through Thursday for elementary students. And so that's big. Four Oak Cliff will continue to support both community and school initiatives. The Frito-Lay Resource Center, located on the second floor, will provide students and community stakeholders job opportunities. The Dallas Cowboys Kevon Frazier drop-in center, located on the first floor, will offer transient families and student uniform support. Regardless of the aforementioned, the most essential factor with reculturing 75216 is the success of this institution. Modern facilities not only improve the school's physical environment, more significantly, it positively impacts the learning culture. Nevertheless, the building alone can't infuse the vision and passion that guides this school's development. Instead, it's the human spirit and the interaction between students, staff, and central stakeholders that will eventually make the difference. The evidence of this relationship is why we're here today. To the SOC community and school leadership, this ceremony would never have happened without your vision, advocacy, negotiation, and cooperation. And I thank you. Finally, I want to thank school leadership and the South Oak Cliff community alumni for allowing me to be the last principal of the old building and the first principal of the new building. As well, lead such a significant project and this learning institution. We all know that SOC is the original number one. SOC, that's who we be.
And then as the principal of South Oak Cliff High School, and again, for all of his hard work. Now again, to some people, you know him as Principal Johnson. To some of our alumni, you might know him as Coach Johnson, or Mr. Johnson when he was a teacher here at South Oak Cliff High School. So we want to recognize him, as always, for all of his hard work and dedication, for the new increase of enrollment here at South Oak Cliff High School, our distinctions that we have in the state of Texas, and so much more. So thank you, Dr. Johnson, for all of your hard work. And again, at this time, we'll have Maxie Johnson, District 5 trustee.
I want to give honor to God, who is the head of my life, to Dr. Hinojosa, President Henry, Mayor Johnson, to the Board of Trustees, and all elected officials that are here today, to my granddaughter, Harmony, who's in the back right there, Marie Apple and Marquise Hawkins, thank you so much. I want to thank everyone for coming out this morning. This is a historic day for the South Oak Cliff community. Many people have fought to make this day happen. This effort was started by kids who wanted a building free of distraction and a safe learning environment to learn in. When I was the PTA president 4 years ago, I received a call that said my son was leading a student protest. I thought they was playing. I am proud today that he, along with the students, are here to celebrate their hard work. It is important to understand that kids started this movement. No elected official started this. As a parent, I supported this effort along with the South Burr Cave alumni, Pastor Nolan, and the Southwest Coalition for Better Schools, Taylor Torrance and Fort Oak Cliff, Minister Dominique Alexander and Next Generation Action Network, Pastor Haynes, they are there, and many others. As trustee of District 5, I will continue to advocate what was promised to our kids. Since elected to trustee, certain obstacles, including those that were racially motivated, tried to stand in the way of what all kids deserve, and particularly the black community. We know that the black and brown community has been disenfranchised for decades. And I want to send a message to those that try to stand in our way. All kids matter. Kids should not be judged by the color of their skin or the zip code they live in. All kids matter. We are all God's children, and he put us here for a reason. Educational inequities leads to poverty. Poverty leads to violence. And if we want to stop the violence, let's educate all kids. I was not elected to be trustee to make friends. I was elected to trustee to do a job, and I'm going to do that job. This building is a place where kids can be safe and proud of. This is just the beginning. As your trustee, you can look forward to seeing Roosevelt getting what they deserve, Pinkston getting what they deserve, O.W. Holmes getting what they deserve. Every school in District 5 will get what they deserve. Why? Because there's a new trustee in District 5. Truly, I can't do this by myself. It's going to take the Board of Trustees and the administration to work together, and we are doing that. I thank God for our Board of Trustees. I want to thank Dakita, KAI, and a special thanks to Dr. Willie Johnson. Sock came from an F school to receiving 4 distinctions while in transition. Again, to Dakita, to KAI, to Mama and Papa Stevenson, I see you out there. Thank you for everything that you do for our kids, even times when there's no cameras around. Late night, you are there. To our community liaison, Brother Derry Batty. And his lovely wife. To the Pinkston alumni that I see in the audience, and to the Tony Johnson, Roosevelt alumni who stand, we are one in District 5. As I close, the Bible declares in Nehemiah 4 and 6, it says, so they built the wall because the people had a mind to work. This is a result of kids and community leaders having a mind to work. When we come together, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. All you have to do is trust God and trust yourself and know in all these things, we are more than conquerors. Congratulations to the community, to the students, to the kids, and to the leadership of District 5. We are one. God bless you, and let's enjoy this day together.
Trustee Johnson, and as always, it's a blessing when you have the opportunity, when we have parents that are so involved, not just in their students' education here, but everyone. Everyone matters here. And we're just so thankful for you and all your hard work and everything that you have done for South Oak Cliff High School, and not just South Oak Cliff High School, but the entire district. And even when you're tired, you still go and try to make a difference in our community. So we would like to support you and just present to you a plaque of appreciation just to say thank you. Last but not least, we have at this time none other than Dr. Michael Hinojosa, Superintendent of Dallas ISD Schools.
Thank you so much for being here, and thank you for honoring this great school on this great day. And Trustee Johnson said it right, the students. I don't call them kids because a lot of them are adults and I don't want to call them a kid. But I'm very proud, and he's right. And at the center of this whole project was the students. But these students couldn't benefit from this great opportunity without a lot of support. And at the top of that support was the school board. It was multiple board members who served this district. It's multiple board members who served this board. And in the spirit of compromise, the board came together to come up with the plan that is being implemented today. And so I want to thank them first and foremost. So give the Board of Trustees a round of applause. Second of all, I want to thank the staff. And the staff, yes, it couldn't have happened without the warrior, Dr. Willie Johnson. He was the leader of making it all happen. So let's thank Dr. Johnson. But there were a lot of staff members involved in this, from custodians to maintenance workers to people from the senior staff at the school district to people in this school, but especially the teachers who helped during this transition to bring SOC to a new place where now we're proud of their performance and only can see higher performance. So let's give all of the staff that was involved a round of applause. Here's what I learned a long time ago. If you're working together for the students, you got the board, and you got the staff, and the third part of the triangle is the community. And oh my goodness, did the community come out? And we're so proud of you for being vocal. We're so proud of you for being committed. We didn't always agree, but in the end, it wasn't your way or my way, it was a better way. And that's what we ended up with, is a much better solution here at South Oak Cliff because of the community was present, vocal, and supportive. And here we have elected officials who are here enjoying what they want for this community because they represent this community. So I want to thank them for that. And so I will finish with my favorite saying, those who say things can't get done get interrupted by people who are doing them. Let's have a great day.
Let's give another round of applause to Dr. Hinojosa. And as always, we just always want to just give a little small token of appreciation, just to say thank you. Just thank you for supporting South Oak Cliff High School, the teachers, the faculty and staff, the students, the alumni, the community leaders of this prestigious community. We really appreciate all that you do for Dallas ISD. Thank you. Now at this time, We are thankful and also would like to recognize some of our elected officials that have came and decided to celebrate with us. At this time, I know we have a few people. Of course, we want to start with, I know he's not here at the moment, but we'd like to recognize Texas Senator Royce West, who was not able to make it. However, he did present a proclamation for South Oak Cliff High School. Also, we have in our presence Dallas Councilwoman Carolyn King Arnold from District 4. That's with us today as well. Now, at this time, I will ask these individuals to please come, and they have some proclamations that they would like to present to the faculty, staff, and students of South Oak Cliff High School. And we would first like to start with our U.S. Representative, Eddie Bernice Johnson.
Hello, South Oak Cliff. You know, a long time ago, there was a book written that said that a child shall lead you. Well, we're here this morning or today because children led us. No one is more important than the future of any place. And so we have to focus on children. And like Dr. Inahosa just said, we know some of you are adults too. You know, it goes to show you that when you speak out in a democracy, you can be heard. And so I congratulate those students who demanded better facilities. Facilities have a great meaning for students. If it's all run down and leaking, then they feel that nobody cares. But to speak up and to be heard by the superintendent and the board members and the community, you see that results can be had. So congratulations, South Oak Cliff students. This is for you. I am proud to be able to share this, and I'm sorry I won't be able to stay the rest of the time because my day has been scheduled for me to be all over the place. But I couldn't miss this, and I want to acknowledge every elected official and every person here, parents and students, who have come. Even one of the ones who helped to cut the ribbon this morning, there was an early graduate of South Oak Cliff. Congratulations to you. I greet you, and I'm delighted to share this occasion with you. We all know that education continues to be the most important investment we can make. And it is clear that when you show students that you are interested and invest in places for them to learn, they will show you results. So thank you, school board. Thank you, Dr. Inahosa. Dr. Inahosa and I go back a long ways through my sister, who claims, both of them claim, that they worked together years ago and developed similar type styles. But Dr. Inahosa, I want to appreciate you for calming this school district down and focusing on the right thing. And I cannot say too much about the cooperation and the leadership of the board. Now, Dr. Blackburn was my school board representative for many years. And I just didn't like it when he said he was going to retire. But he was replaced by Reverend Johnson, that I summoned in to get to meet him to see where his heart was and where his interest was. And I approve of him. I want to express my appreciation for all of the school board members and the new leadership that we have, because we can see and feel much of the closeness to the community. And we know how important your job is, because you really mold the future. And Oak Cliff, all of you who have graduated and the ones who are on the program today, let me congratulate you. Never forget to be loyal to your institution. It does make a difference. This week, I had a flag flown over the Capitol, especially for South Oak Cliff. And so I want to present it. And the certificate reads, this is to certify that the accompanying flag was flown over the United States Capitol at the request of Eddie Bernice Johnson, Member of Congress, in honor of South Oak Cliff High School. Thank you, and we'll celebrate by continuing to invest in our future, and our future consists of our students. Thank you.
What an honor. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Now this time we will have, and also this is a time to trace, we are asking all of our elected officials for a minute or two for their proclamations and such. At this time, we will now have our Texas Representative, Carl Sherman, to please come to the stage.
To the Dallas ISD School Board Trustees, Dr. Johnson, Dr. Hinojosa, to the mayor of South Oak Cliff, Brother Batty. To the hard-fighting soldiers of the community who ensured that we have 52 million reasons to be here this morning. I am standing as your state representative, proud to represent you and this community, as well as Senator West, with a proclamation from the Senate of the State of Texas. Whereas I've been given 1 minute, I will respect that 1 minute. I had some words from Langston Hughes, but I will respect that 1 minute. Whereas the Senate of the State of Texas is pleased to recognize the administrators, faculty, and staff of South Oak Cliff High School of the Dallas Independent School District on the occasion of the January 11th, 2020 ribbon cutting ceremony in honor of the school's additions and renovations. And whereas, proclaim that a copy of this proclamation be prepared for the school as an expression of high regard from the state of Texas. We are here because you were committed to make this happen. And because of you, all the high schools in this district will be the benefactors of your hard work. Thank you. God bless you. We love you, state of Texas.
We're gonna have a good time, because again, this is a celebration for our students, the faculty, and staff. And also, we gotta make room for our keynote speaker, so you don't wanna miss that one. Also, at this time, I would like to ask none other than Texas Representative and alumni, Tony Rhodes.
Everyone. Any sock bears in the house? I am State Representative Tony Rhodes, and I proudly represent Texas House District 110 in the Texas House of Representatives. But Dr. Johnson, I want you to do me a favor. I need you to redo this program. You can just make one copy, and up under my name, make sure you put Texas State Representative Tony Rhodes, class of 1986. document and put it in my office. But it is indeed a glorious occasion today. I am so honored to be here, and I know I have a minute, but I'm gonna take two. And I am so proud to be here. When I walked into this building today, it was kind of surreal. You know, it was kind of a full circle moment, because when I was a student here at South Oak Cliff, I served as president of the Student Senate, and you know, now I serve in the Texas House. And I thought about it, I was like, well, that was the first time I was elected. So this is where I became a leader. So the students, all of you who are in the Student Government Association, hey, it's just the beginning. One of the things that I thought about too as I came in the building, I just kind of thought about some few things, and I was just sharing with the commissioner. He didn't even remember, but you know, he slept since then. That's been about 30 years. But when he was first elected as the first black county commissioner here in Dallas County, my 10th grade government class with Mr. Lockhart, went down to the county commissioner's office, and he took us around the commissioner's court and educated us on the commissioner court. And as I said, thank you, Dean. I'm going to thank you again today, commissioner, for that. You know, one of my favorite quotes is, never doubt that a small group of concerns, I might be paraphrasing it, small committed citizens could change the world, because indeed it's the only thing that ever has. So I want to thank the students who were here at that time and those who are still here, who took it upon themselves to stand up for South Oak Cliff. We really appreciate you. And if you're here, could you just stand up? All of the students who participated in the protest. Thank you, thank you. I know they're going to be acknowledged in a few minutes, but I just wanted to acknowledge him on behalf of the Texas House Representative. Now, I have my colleague, Carl Sherman, which Representative Sherman represents South Oak Cliff, but we do know that South Oak Cliff is what? My school, right? Okay. So we share South Oak Cliff, and so we have a resolution, and I'm going to let him do the resolution.
All right. Whereas South Oak Cliff High School is celebrating the completion of an addition and extension renovations with a ribbon-cutting ceremony on January 11, 2020, and whereas, resolved that the ribbon cutting for the South Oak Cliff High School addition and renovation project be commemorated, and that all those associated with the campus be extended sincere best wishes for continued success. And as Pastor Bradford the Fourth said, let the Spirit of God dwell in this place and continue for excellence. God bless you.
Also, just know that you have advocates, and I can really say this for the entire delegation of the Texas House of Representatives. We are here for you in the Texas House. Anything that we can do to be of service, please do not hesitate to contact any one of us. Thank you. SOSOC.
Speaking of commissioner, we will now have no other Dallas County Commissioner, John Wiley Price.
I'm going to try to stay within my minute range here. But okay, thank you. let me just say to the Board of Trustees, to Dr. Hinojosa, to Dr. Johnson, to the other elected officials here, and to our keynote speaker, thank you. When we sang a few minutes ago, I went over to Madam Chair Toni Rose and said, you know, the travesty is, we keep talking about, oh, say, can you see. And we seem to not even understand James Weldon Johnson, who said, lift every voice. That's all David was saying, since everybody wants to get theological, in those 150 Psalms. Lift every voice and sing. But what are we singing? We don't even understand, full of the faith that the dark path has taught us, full of the hope that the present has brought us. And so, not to be confused with our keynote speaker today, Dr. Frederick Douglass Haynes III, my tie, Dr. Johnson says, what Frederick Douglass said, it's easier to build strong children than to repair broken men. So today, I'm not going to read all the whereases, but I'm not going to let this moment pass, because the Jewish proverb says that education is not what you get. Education is what you do. And so I just come by here today to help celebrate some of your famous alumni, the Dennis Rodmans of the world, the Harvey Martin of the world, the Christy Gaines of the world, the David Browns of the world, and the Dr. Frederick Todd Jr. of the world. And so as I go to my seat, I'm going to tell y'all, at the end of the day, Frederick Todd put South Oak Cliff on the map. I ain't going to never let you forget it. He was not only premier in terms of education, in terms of athletics, but in terms of academics. That's the reason, Dr. Hinojosa, that this school district recognized that when he left South Oak Cliff, they took him down to the general office. Long live the spirit of Frederick Todd in terms of South Oak Cliff.
Good afternoon, everyone. As she said, first, when we redo the schedule for any of these events, please, behind Commissioner Price, I do not want to be ever again. I'm not a pastor, I'm not Commissioner Price, but I will sit here and speak truth. My name's Justin Henry, I'm the school board president of DISD. Before I do anything, I'm going to stick to my time. I want to acknowledge my colleagues that serve on the board with me today. I saw a few of us here. I'll start with your great representative, Chesty Johnson. Through this whole process, and this hasn't been a smooth process, as he said, I've developed three email folders in my email box. One is for SOC, one is for Trustee Johnson, and the rest is for the SOC alumni. So I'm talking about hundreds of emails. So when you talk about advocacy and how we get to this point where we're at right now, it's not without the community. This came initially from a bond in 2015. That's where the funds initially came. That's where the funds are moved around. But if you don't hold us accountable for where these bond monies go, if you don't show up at the board meetings, if you don't make me create another email box in the next few years for Lincoln and Madison and Roosevelt and et cetera, then we continue to get to these places. That's how we get to these places. So it takes the policy, but it takes the advocacy. And if I could ask my colleagues on the board just to stand briefly, because this really, you can't get anything done on our board as an individual. You're going to at least need 5 votes. And some of them are here. Trustee Foreman, who you all know very well, Trustee Garcia, the youngest and the first, I believe, Latina to sit on our board. Trustee Mitch K. I saw Trustee Mackey here earlier. I don't, Trustee Solis was here as well earlier. And I definitely acknowledge the administration, Dr. Hinojosa, and your leadership, his team and staff, which is over here on my right. So on behalf of the school board, DISD, our trustees, we're happy that this was able to be done for the South Oak Cliff community. I bet earlier this season that Skyline was going to beat Sauk in the football game. I lost. I had to say, hold on, chill out. I know it's y'all's day. I had to wear a Sauk shirt to the board meeting. One of the things I learned from that process and what I've seen here is you don't bet against Sauk. So on that note, go Bears.
Councilwoman Carolyn King Arnold of District 4 to please come to the stage.
Once again, I assume now as we're in the afternoon, but I'll simply say good day. Is it not a good day in the southern part of Dallas, South Oak Cliff? Is it a good day? Yes, it is. I am Councilwoman Carolyn King Arnold, representing District 4. I am standing here because the mayor had to leave, and he also asked that I give his remarks in terms of the resolution. After the words of my favorite county commissioner, it's hard to stand here by myself. So I'm going to ask my council members, Jaime Resendez, to join me. Where are my other council members? Because as we move in this city, we're going to move together. Adam Magoo was here earlier. He's here. But as we, and here's Casey Thomas. Come on up as well. Now, we know we have about 2 minutes, and we're going to do the best that we can do. But it is going to take not only, and let me back up first to say thank you to the board trustees, Dr. Hinojosa, whom I work with and admire and appreciate the fact that he did come back to Dallas. You may have walked out, but you walked back in. And we appreciate that so much, Dr. Hinojosa. Also to the faculty of Sauk, we say thank you. The alumni, the staff, but also I have to give a nod to the liaison of whom I work with and talk to constantly. Mr. Derek Battee, you must stand. And I know we call his name quite often, and I would love to dedicate this resolution, of course, to your hard work. But from the city of Dallas, we are too will not read all the whereases, but I want to say we are joined in forces because we realize we are in a state of emergency here in 16224, 75224, 75232, and other districts. And we're going to work hard to make sure that we are pushing for the economic equity, social justice that we are entitled to in this district. But I thought a few days ago when asked to speak, what would I say? I thought about a poem, but I made it up, but I'm not going to share all of it with you, but it's called Walking Out and Walking In Again. A new story now begins. And so now you have an opportunity to stand and deliver. You cannot just come here today and feel good from the words that are shared with you from this mic. You have to be about the business of education. Now we're here to work with you. I'm committed. Be about the business of education. Knowledge is power. You now have an opportunity, a mandate as students in this building to become knowledgeable, well-informed, civic-minded individuals. But it's going to take all of us in this building to make sure that when we pass the baton to these young individuals, that we are passing a baton of accountability, involvement, and advocacy. And so it cannot just be here today, as I stated, to feel good, to see the balloons, to eat and dance to the music. Is it about taking care of business? We can start today in this community, reaching out to our senior citizens, reaching out to make sure this is the type of community that you want to change so when you come back 20 years from now, you can see the fruits of your labor. And so with that, I'm going to share the words, just a few, from the mayor of the city of Dallas as he speaks for all of us around the horseshoe. Whereas the mission of the South Oak Cliff is to educate, empower, and equip youth in the South Oak Cliff community with the tools to succeed in life. Whereas South Oak Cliff has a thriving alumni association that remains engaged. Whereas the South Oak Cliff community has come together on January 11th, 2020 to celebrate the reopening of the school by hosting a ribbon cutting ceremony and the March for the Community. Now, therefore, I, Eric Johnson, Mayor of the City of Dallas, do proclaim January 11th, 2020 as South Oak Cliff Day in Dallas, Texas. So we thank you very much, but remember the words of Frederick Douglass. Frederick Douglass says, "The struggle continues." Thank you.
Again, thank you to everyone for your proclamations and remarks to South Oak Cliff High School. Also, at this time, before we start, I know we have our amazing alumni, as always, to come to support our students, but I definitely want to make a few more recognitions. Starting with our class of 1956, Mr. and Mrs. Edmond. Came out and supported and had fun with us in our celebration march, so we thank you. We also like to recognize all of our older alumni as well from the class of you and from the 50s. Please stand. If you're from the 1960s, would you please stand? So again, we thank you so much for laying the foundation and the hard work for South Oak Cliff High School. Also, well, a lot of people don't know, we also have our Grand Marshal here, none other than Mrs. Barbara Brown McCoy. We please stand. Who is one of our most phenomenal alumni, as we consider a legend, and that also show us the epitome of a legacy here at South Oak Cliff High School. So let's give her a round of applause. At this time, we have a small video presentation that we would like to show to you. And then, of course, we would like to introduce to you none other than the four students that started it all. Please watch.
Potentially dangerous conditions as students are forced to study right next to exposed electrical wires under leaky roofs and even in hallways when the heating and cooling systems don't work.
Comfortable environment, and that's what we want, a comfortable environment. We have tests we need to pass, and if it's a comfortable environment, then how can we pass our tests? How can we stay focused to get the information to pass the test?
New space, and they've also learned through this process that when even poor communities raise their voices together, they can be heard.
Everybody's so excited, they're astonished by it. They're like, oh wow, this wasn't here, that wasn't here.
Sophomore Horace Bradshaw, the sixth.
My dad, my uncle, my grandpa.
Was born to be a golden bear.
Me and my dad drove by almost every day to see it. and it was awesome. A dream come true.
He and the community watched as the aging but beloved campus underwent a $52 million renovation. Changes made possible after students staged walkouts demanding equity.
It empowers them, motivates them.
Principal Willie Johnson says the changes aren't just cosmetic.
Too ready, seen, go.
There are new spaces for arts, athletics, and collaborative learning.
It gives them a sense of pride that their performance means something.
What would your dad say?
My dad would say, make sure they keep it clean.
And Horace has something to say to the students who fought for changes that they wouldn't get to enjoy and the community leaders who backed them.
Thank you. Thank you very much for your hard work, and it's paid off definitely. And I hope you come back to see what you have done for us.
Now this time, ladies and gentlemen, present to you Sark Fab Four. David Johnson, Lizette Godinez, Landon Finley, and Taya Mitchell.
Y quiero tomar el tiempo para darle las gracias a todos los padres, todos los maestros que han estado con nosotros apoyándonos desde el principio. Y pues darle las gracias a los estudiantes que han estado con nosotros desde el principio y a los que van empezando. Ojalá que disfruten de la escuela y que tomen el ejemplo de que pusimos y pues que sepan que pueden pelear por lo que creen. Y unidos podemos hacer nuestros sueños realidad. Gracias.
Good afternoon. So before I start, to give y'all a good perspective of what we endured as students, I'm going to say a few specific things that happened when I was a senior. So in 2015, our alma mater really had one of the worst school buildings in DISD. It was impossible to teach efficiently in it. SOC didn't have ceiling tiles and pipes were exposed throughout the school. If you stayed for an extended amount of time, I'm positive that you would forget about the unbearable appearance and start to think about the unbearable conditions. The temperature, whether you were freezing cold or in unbearable heat, wasn't dependent upon the degrees of the AC, but the temperature outside, the day of the week. Some teachers even resorted to teaching classes in the hallway because the classrooms were so bad. The restrooms, even when clean, had a lingering odor as soon as you opened the door. On rainy days, you would be astounded by the number of trash cans in the hallways just to trap water from the leaky ceilings. I myself have witnessed a ceiling tile fall just missing hitting a student. Those tiles, I picked up one of those tiles, they're very heavy. It probably took a lot just to move it to the cafeteria where it fell. We have even seen gas leaks, electrical fires, rats, the list goes on, people. Termites, all types of things. There were even discoveries, and this is important, of asbestos. If you know about the things of asbestos, it can cause cancer. After years and years, it can cause cancer. And they had students walking in between these hallways while they're actually, I remember actually going up under in the basement, and people were actually working on the ceiling, and it was dust. You can't even see. And it was dust, and the people that are working have, they have caps on their head, but students are walking around with backpacks like it's normal. It just, there wasn't safe conditions at all. So after a $1.6 billion bond was passed by Dallas County voters, we were sure we would get the funding we needed. Sadly, the district didn't give us the funds necessary.
As students, we took this very personal. We had questions that needed to be answered. How could you expect for us to learn in this environment? Is there anyone besides us concerned? Does our health matter? Does our education matter? We decided to join together and become the voice for SOC. They called us the Fab Four. We knew we wouldn't experience being in a new school. We knew this wasn't gonna, we wasn't gonna see it. We wasn't gonna be able to learn in it. But it wasn't for us. It was for the generations after us, the students after us. We organized walkouts, campouts, long speaking protests at board meetings, and we went to pretty much every board meeting. We contacted media outlets such as radio stations, news outlets, all social media. We even have a Twitter. It's called Stand With SOC if you guys want to follow us. I'm sorry. As seniors, we risked a lot, like our prom, graduation, still being students of South Oak Cliff. Our own principal, along with other staff administrators, threatened everything in our power to silence us. But our efforts were noticed. Eventually, hundreds of students, SOC students, alumni, even our class of 2016, because I have to shout them out. The classes after us, 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020, y'all babies in here. Community representatives and alumni participated in the demonstrations that we led. And despite all the hardships today, there's a new multi-million dollar state-of-the-art school. We are so grateful for having the courage to be SOC's voice. This shows that no matter who you are, you can make a change. And I just want to say this because one of my favorite teachers told me this. She said that if you believe in anything or if you believe in yourself, you can go out and build pyramids. Thank you.
How's everybody doing? I'm just simply here to say thank you to each and every individual who played a part in this protest. This was a major thing, and it came with a lot of sacrifice. A lot of teachers got fired, people got their jobs threatened, and now we're here today to what we have. So once again, I just want to thank each and every individual who played a part in getting what we have today. Thank you.
So at this time, we want to do something that kind of symbolizes what has been going on at South Oak Cliff High School. We believe in teaching the new generation, and they will teach the next generation. So, of course, we have our own alumni president, Reverend Horace Bradshaw, that will pass the baton to our South Fab Four. And, of course, our South Fab Four will pass it on to our class representatives, our 2021, 2022, 2023, and 2024 students. They also homecoming core, y'all. And no other than our future South Oak Cliff alumni and South Oak Cliff Bears. So as an alumni, and just to kind of tell you guys, we are so proud of y'all. We are so proud of all the things that you have done here at South Oak Cliff High School, what you have even done even after you graduated. And it gives us honor so much, and we are so proud of you. And with that being said, to our SOC Fab Four, it just started. And also with that being said, we would like to present to you a few awards to say thank you for starting the movement. To birthing a movement, not just at South Oak Cliff High School, but throughout all of Dallas ISD. As you get your award, can you please also step to my left? Now, as our SOC Fab 4 has given us a charge, not just to the school, but to the community, it's only right for our class president of the class of 2020, Taisha Brown, come and receive the charge from the SOC Fab 4.
Thank you all so much. We really appreciate it. As the senior class president of the senior class of 2020, woo! We accept this charge, and we really would like to say thank you all, and we will continue the legacy. Thank you.
All right, guys, we almost there. Now this time we will have another performance by our South Oak Cliff High School Choir, Total Praise. And then we will have special presentations from Minister Dominique Alexander, president and founder of Next Generation Action Network. And of course, we'll be coming back to hear from our keynote speaker.
Thank you. awesome choir in hand. I won't be long because this program has went more longer than what it is expected. But I want to say thank you, first off, to the superintendent, Dr. Michael Hinojosa. I want to say thank you to Trustee Maxie Johnson. I want to say thank you to, I say, my road dog principal, Dr. Jake. We've been all through this building all week long, making sure that everything is all right. I want to say thank you to the Fab Four. Y'all give them a hand. I want to say thank you to the class of 2016 who stood on the auditorium balcony and entrusted on what I was asking them to do. They didn't know me. They didn't know me, but they understood what they were going through in this building. Their leadership from David, Taya, Lizette, and Landon is what started a movement, and it was a movement. A movement that spread it throughout and made this district rethink what equity looks like. December 7, 2015 is when this movement was born here at South Oak Cliff High School. Now, I'm not going to say a number because I've heard 62 and I've heard 52. But however, it's more than what has ever been invested in this school. I tell this story also because I am not a South Oak Cliff graduate. I started here as a freshman. I graduated from A. Maceo Smith High School, 2007. No one has to understand the legacy that A. Maceo Smith fostered and the man that he was here in Dallas and throughout this country. That's what gave me the spirit of activism that we do at the Next Generation Action Network. I'm gonna be very brief with this. My grandmother bought a house in 1955, right there at 3618 Merlin Avenue, one block away from here. At that time, my grandfathers could not go to South Oak Cliff High School. I say to this today, this community, it was a man named Sam Tasby that now has a trustee like Trustee Johnson that can represent us. Dr. Hinojosa, if it wasn't for Sam Tasby, you would not be the superintendent of Dallas ISD. The minority leadership that we see in this district would not exist because of that. So I say to our ancestors, I say to the people who have laid the foundation for us to do the work that we do, like Commissioner John Wiley Price and all of the people who have labored before us, and my mother, Trustee Joyce Foreman. I shouldn't have told y'all that because I'm giving y'all a secret weapon. Don't call her. Don't call her. But other than that, I want to say this because Trustee Foreman is the one who stood out on the front lawn with us when those kids walked out. Her leadership and as well as Trustee Nuttall's leadership helped organize, and they were the ones that allowed their other colleagues and expressed to their other colleagues why South Oak Cliff and that investment was needed inside of 3601. So I want to say thank you to Trustee Foreman and Trustee Nuttall. When you talk about a movement, you talk about yet a son, David Johnson, walking out, and yet now you see at whatever building, because I don't know the address no more, but at the end of the day, you see his dad now represent the school board trustee representation. That is what we're talking about. When you start a movement, that's historical. Right here from South Oak Cliff, we have our own trustee, Maxie Johnson. So I want to say thank you to Pastor Maxie Johnson as well. Last but not least, it is a joy to walk around this building and ask kids, thank you, and see kids say thank you to you. See kids say thank you for keeping the ground, keeping staying at it, keeping the meetings. I have walked through all parts of this building, but I must say thank you to our committee who organized this event, SOC alum, Southwest Coalition members, a lot of different members who allowed for this to go on. I must say thank you to my staff, Next Generation Action Network, and our board of directors that allow me to do what I do as the president of that organization. But also, I must say, last but not least, kids, take care of this building. It is yours. It is yours. Around the time when we walked out, they said we were distractions. But guess what? 4 years later, we got four distinctions on the front of the building that we wasn't a distraction. South Oak Cliff has never returned to the IR list, an unacceptable list. And thank you to Dr. Johnson and his staff. We're gonna ace that text test like never, that STAR test like never before. Y'all know how long I've been in school. It was text when I was in school. My bad, I'm sorry. But at the end of the day, y'all take care of this, because there are kids that stood on that balcony that remember this one thing, and I'll move on to the thing. One of the things I told them is that they will never see what they fought for. For this is for the next generation. And they made that sacrifice knowing that you guys were going to reap the benefits. So in the spirit of Dr. King, in the spirit of Rosa Parks, all of them people knew that they were doing something that we can benefit now today. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. In the spirit of, we have some special recognitions that we want to bring. We want to also acknowledge our project management team, Dakita Engineering, program manager, President Eva Williams. Can you please come to the stage? Oh, and Chairman Lucius Williams, please come to the stage, please, please. We ask that Darren from KAI come, please. We ask that a representative from Roger O'Brien, please. And if I can have my NGAN staff help me. One of the things that we asked for, we wanted African American representation and people that built our school. So give a hand for KAI and Dakita Enterprise Incorporated. So for the efforts of time, most of the people, we're gonna give the awards after the program, but we must acknowledge Reverend Nolan, Dr. Frederick Todd, Derek Batty, at the NAACP, Southwest Coalition, all of the people, the Next Generation Action Network Excel team, Damon Crenshaw, all of the people who will be receiving their plaques after this. Also, from the Wild Wild West, any 2020 West Wheatland Rose in here. I want to bring to you my pastor, Dr. the Magnificent, the person who put it like nobody else, Dr. Frederick Haynes III.
Let me offer my congratulations to the South Oak Cliff community, especially
this amazing high school. And of course, this school is reflective of the Fab Four, who I want to salute in these few moments. I recognize the hour is late, so I won't hold you long at all. I want to talk about still undefeated. I think it's Meek Mill who has on his album Miguel. Miguel says, we still undefeated, can you believe it? It was designed for us to fail, but we prevailed through the hell. Can you believe it? We're still undefeated. It was designed for us to lose, but we made it through. Nothing is impossible. We still undefeated. South Oak Cliff, you still undefeated. It was designed for you to fail, but you made it through the hell. And because you made it through the hell, boom, this is where we are this day, because we are still undefeated. Now here we are in the midst of this glory, but we can never have amnesia about the story that led up to this magnificent moment. Of course, the glory is this magnificent facility, but the story is the sad reality that our children had to fight to get out of a sick, toxic environment that they never should have had to fight for to begin with. It was a fight that they never should have had, but because they had the fight and fought the good fight, boom, here we are, here right now, still undefeated, designed for us to fail, but we prevailed in spite of the hell. With that being the case, may we remember that just as there was a Little Rock Nine in Little Rock, Arkansas, just as there was a distinguished group of college students who sat in that we might desegregate Jim and Jane Crow segregation in this nation, just as the Birmingham movement turned when young people marched into the jails, we want to say that when you write the history books, add to the Little Rock Nine, add to those students who sat in the Fab Four right here at South Oak Cliff High School, because they teach us some lessons. I give you the lessons and I'm dumb. Lesson number one is, when you are first class, don't you settle for second class conditions. I think I just said something. Whenever you know you are first class, you refuse to settle for second class conditions. No wonder Carter G. Woodson in The Miseducation of the Negro said, when you control someone's thinking, you ain't gotta tell them to sit here and go yonder. They find their own place. And you ain't even got to tell them to go into a back door, because when you have a back door mentality, the front door will never do. But isn't it good to know that Langston Hughes said, Negro, sweet and docile, humble, meek and kind. But you better watch out for the day when we change our minds. And that's what happened here at South Hope Oak Cliff High School. The Fab Four said, we're going to change our minds. We will not inhale asbestos. We will not drink contaminated water. We will not settle for second class citizenship, because when you are first class, you don't settle for second class conditions. But not only that, we learned from this experience, and I salute not just the Fab Four, but the community that rose up behind him and said, we're not going to take this. Because whenever you have a healthy village does not permit sick predators to prey on our children. And so I salute the healthy village that rose up and stood up. I saw National Geographic, Pastor Wilson, Commissioner Price, a scene that blew me away. A buffalo, a young calf, got away from the rest of the herd. But check out what happened. Some lion predators came to get that little calf. But as soon as the rest of the herd saw what was going on, they ran right back to surround the den of lions. The next thing you know, they surrounded the calf that had been caught by the lions, and they ran off the lions. The lions had to give it up. Here's what the narrator said. The narrator said, that young calf has a future because the herd came together. And I'm simply trying to say, every time the herd comes together, we ensure our children have a future.
future. I got one last lesson, and the last lesson is this. Now we have a fabulous facility. Mr. Principal, keep doing your thing to make sure our children are equipped and empowered with an excellent education. You see, it's one thing to have a facility. It's another thing to facilitate an education. Y'all miss your chef. I'll see if I can help you out right quick. I can help you out right quick. I'll give it to you like this. I think it was the Black Panther Party. They were admired in the Bay Area because you had the dapper brothers and sisters dressed in black and their berets, and they understood the wisdom of Big Sean, because Big Sean threw down like this by saying, more dangerous than a loaded weapon is a loaded mind. And so check out what happened. The Black Panthers are killing it in them streets. They are policing the police. They are serving breakfast to the impoverished. They are raising up the hood in East Oakland. A young cat saw what they were doing, went to the Black Panther Party and said, yo, I want to join. And as soon as he said that, guess what happened? He was given by Huey Newton, Commissioner, a stack of books. And when he got the stack of books, he said, hold on, I thought y'all were going to arm me with the weapon. And Huey Newton said, I just armed you right there. I armed you with what you need to arm your mind and make your mind a dangerous weapon of liberation. So Brother Petit, thank you, because you are about that life. And I guess I can wrap it up like this. Mr. Principal, here's what we're going to do. We're going to arm our children to make sure they academically can think for themselves and not just train for a test. We are going to arm our children to believe in themselves when nobody else believes in themselves. We're going to arm our children to create a brand new nation. We're going to arm our children to be equipped and empowered to stand up and speak up and refuse to sit down and give up. We're going to arm our children with the faith that the dark past has taught us and the hope that the present has brought us. We're going to arm our children, because when you have a loaded mind, it's better than a loaded weapon. So let's arm our children, because our children here are to let us know we done been through the hell, but we still prevailed. We are still undefeated. South Oak Cliff, S-O-C, you are undefeated.
Y'all give him a hand. Dr. Haynes, we have a token appreciation. As a senior pastor, we know that you don't do things alone. So we have a plaque to Friendship West Baptist Church, always, for y'all commitment to social justice under the leadership of Minister Danielle Ayers and all of your staff. We want to say thank you. And that plaque to you, Dr. Haynes. Also, real quick, after this, we're going to call up some organizations real quick and give these plaques out. I would like representatives from NAACP to come up, 4 Oak Cliff, NGAN Excel, South Oak Cliff Birdcave, Southwest Coalition, Paradise Missionary Baptist Church, representatives from Southwest Coalition. Dr. Todd, can you come up here for the Southwest Coalition? Come on. Where's Reverend Nolan? Reverend Nolan? And we would like to thank George Castro for being a strong advocate for District 5. Thank you for your leadership.
All right.
Alrighty, our program is now in the hands. Our mistress of ceremony, Brianna Hall. Oh, David Wilson's here.
As you exit, there will be tours available. If you would like to see the school for yourself, we have a few students with tour signs. You can see them by the learning stairs towards the left. Please make sure you're able to see them. Go outside of Legacy Hall. At this time, we will have our closing prayer by our very own Reverend David Wilson.
Can we pray together for one moment? Out of all that God has done, we ought to go down from this place just thanking Him. Eternal God, how we praise and thank you again for this occasion, for all that has come forth. We thank you, Lord, through all of the efforts you have again demonstrated just how great a God you are. You have fulfilled your promises in these efforts, and we pray, oh God, that we not forget, but that we continue, Lord, to light a flame and to stir up the gift in these young people, that they be great contributors to our society, in Jesus' name. Now unto Him who's able to keep us from falling, may He keep us until we meet. And all of the people said together, amen. Amen.